everyone, it's David, and I'm an empath and an intuitive. I help people to open up, understand the issues that might be plaguing them, and with the help of spirit, help them work through those issues. So working with me means you're working with me, and you're working with spirit too. And so we've been discussing empaths and productivity, and I really am kind of stoked about speaking to your home situation, because to me, it's been really interesting. You know, you think about all that you invest in, and you think to yourself, hey, you know, I'm going to live here, and then I'm going to take, like, let's say 2 weeks of vacation, if we ever get that, right? And that's how I'm going to kind of work things out. But we never really, you know, or at least most people and my friends never really think about making their home a place where they vacation at, you know. So I'm not doing the cheesy hipster staycation stuff. I'm not talking about trendy things. I'm talking about in real terms, like, for example, a shower head, right? Like, you'll go out and drop $50, no problem, for pizza and a couple of drinks or whatever. But if you spend $50 on a shower head, you'd be like, what am I talking about? Or $100 on a shower head or whatever. But yeah, you use that every day. And you use that every day, how many years straight? And so those kind of things, like readdressing what you're thinking about. So when I think about home and productivity, I really think about home as a recharging place. Now, I happen to work from home as well as live at home or whatever. So for me and Nance, it's really become more of a place that we try to create really cool space and be able to do a lot of different things in. But it's about recharging so that we can go out into the world and feel like we have something to give. You know, when you're at your lowest, or if you're not at your highest, you're not at your best. And then how are you able to share your best with everyone else? And so for when you think about empaths, when you think about all that you're feeling, then you have to think about your home space and what are you doing there to create space for you to be able to let go of, which may need to be a little different spot than where you want to recharge from, right? So I want you to think about that. You may set up a little place in your yard where you walk barefoot around the corner over here to a tree, and that's kind of your letting go stuff, and then you kind of leave the tree and you walk over here and you kind of sit for a minute, and that's kind of your, you know, your uplifting spot, right? You might want to think in terms like that, of using energy and staying in a movement. Really does help to work things out, and you can do that on the inside too, where you had a particular corner that you do certain things in, and then you might have another space over here, much like you would in, you know, your workspace or your desk or whatever. So you'd have a space over here where you can do something else, but it's really about recharging. So the most important thing I can say is that understanding who you are and what you are is obviously the key to you figuring out how to make your life both enjoyable and where you don't feel depleted, which is you know, everyone's issue, it seems like to me, but where you're able to flow with and understand what's coming in and use it, and use it in the most bestest sense possible, obviously not exploitatively, but to be able to feel this. So be a person of light, right? And shine your light and help yourself and help others. And to do that, it's a total package. So really it's about you understanding yourself and then you creating the right type of work environment for yourself where you can optimize the best parts of you and minimize your weaknesses, and as well as how that translates to your home, where you can recharge and feel at peace and feel like this is a safe spot and you don't have a lot of some of the same stimulus, and then you're able to recharge and go back out in the world and do more good. You know, when you are trying to do good, you have a lot of obstacles sometimes, of all sorts of things that would prevent you from executing upon that. And so you, and part of that's how you feel about things, your attitude, your vibe, right? And whether or not you're able to actually execute on what you're supposed to do, a lot of times depends on your attitude and your vibe, and if you're ready for whatever you're called to do next. it's so important that you treat yourself with respect. And just because you grew up saying, hey, I've got to work like this, or, you know, society, and I hate using that term, but, you know, society says, oh, you're going to work behind this desk, or your job's going to look like this. It doesn't have to. That means that you might have to trailblaze a little bit and create something different for yourself, but that could be a really cool experience. It has been for me, and I think if you're it's not for everyone, but if you're the right type of person for that, man, it can be so liberating. So if we can be of service, please let us know. We have free reading, so please check that out on our website. And if you dig what we're doing here in our work, please subscribe and thumbs up. And until next time, be well.